Hello friends, I am Mr. Sanjeev B.Naik, working as Assistant Professor in Mechanical Engineering Department, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. In this video, I am explaining design of worm gears. At the end of the session, students will be able to understand the terminology of worm gears and they will be able to specify the worm gears. As you know, worm gear consists of worm wheel and a worm. The worm is essentially a screw and worm wheel is having helical teeth of helical gears, and that's why the terminology would include terms of the thread and terms for the gear teeth. So PCD of worm is referred as D1, that is pitch circle diameter of the worm is shown as D1 and pitch circle diameter of the worm wheel is shown as D2, whereas the axial pitch for the worm thread is shown as PX and the circular pitch for the teeth on the worm wheel is shown as P. Lead of the worm is shown over here by developing one of the thread of the worm, and that is, we are knowing that the distance covered by a point measured along the axis during one complete rotation of the worm is defined as the lead, and that's why we find that lead L is shown over here as axial distance. The lead angle will be calculated by developing a thread as a gamma over here, and naturally this is shown in this triangle over here. A helix angle of thread is a psi, that is the angle made by the thread with the axis of rotation of the worm is called as the helix angle. The relationship is important for kinematic power transmission condition, that a linear motion of the worm is converted as a rotary motion of the worm wheel, and that's why the axial pitch of the worm must be equal to the circular pitch of the worm wheel as shown over here. So PX is equal to P, that is a condition must. And then from the triangle we know that the tan of gamma is L upon pi D1. So that is the way we can calculate the lead angle gamma. Now practically, worm gears being peculiar in their construction and different than other gears, they are designated or specified by some terms known as Z1, Z2, Q and M. Z1 refers number of stars on the worm, Z2 refers number of teeth on the worm wheel, Q is a diameter quotient, which is a ratio of a pitch circle diameter of the worm divided by axial model of the worm or circular model of the worm wheel, and the diameter quotient is Q, whereas M is the module. So some of the standard references are given to decide the number of start on the worm based upon the velocity ratio. That is, if the velocity ratio is 20 and above, single start threads are recommended. 12 to 36 it is double start, 8 to 12 triple start, so on. So this is a natural guideline given to be used by the designer in deciding the number of start on the worm for economical drive. These are certain preferred values of Z1, Z2, QM for worm gears. The worm gears are many times available as a standard set or standard gearbox as a construction, depending upon the center distance between the shafts. So depending upon transmission ratios, like 20 onwards is given over here, depending upon center distance, we can refer directly some preferred values for Z1, Z2, Q and M for application. So now we have just seen that lead of the worm L can be calculated by axial pitch multiplied by number of start, so PX into Z1. Axial pitch of the worm is equal to circular pitch of the worm wheel, that we have just seen. So PX is equal to pi M, and therefore the value of lead is pi M Z1. So if I want to calculate tan of gamma, that is the lead angle, then it is L upon pi D1, where L is substituted as a pi M Z1, whereas D1 is Q into M, because you have seen that Q diameter quotient is D1 by M. So naturally D1 is equal to Qm2 m, and that's why substituting that also, finally we get tan of gamma, that is the lead angle, is Z1 by Q. So if you are knowing Z1, Z2, Qm as a specification, we can know the gamma angle, that is helix lead angle. Now for worm gas, the requirement is that linear velocity of the worm must be equal to the pitch line velocity of the worm wheel. As we know that worm is transmitting linear motion as a rotary motion to the worm wheel. So linear velocity of the worm should be equal to the pitch line velocity of the worm wheel. Linear velocity of the worm is lead into speed of the worm, that is RPM of the worm. And pitch line velocity is the circumference of the worm wheel, pi d2, into speed of the worm wheel. So substituting the values we get here, velocity ratio is n1 by n2, because pi m gets cancelled, and n1 by n2, which is the velocity ratio, is equal to z2 by z1. That is the speed of worm divided by speed of the worm wheel, called as the velocity ratio, is equal to the number of teeth on the worm wheel divided by number of start on the worm. So this is the way we can define the velocity ratio for worm gear drives. As far as the helix angle side to be calculated, the worm gears are used for transmitting power between two non-intersecting perpendicular shafts. So angle between the shaft is 90 degrees, and that's why psi plus gamma, that is helix angle plus lead angle, must be equal to the angle between the shaft, that is 90 degrees. So helix angle is 90 minus lead angle. So students, now you are expect to pause the video for a while and find out what way the speed ratio for other types of gears that you have calculated so far. Now you go for the proportions of the worm and worm wheel. So here it is a worm in which we get different geometrical dimensions or proportions of the thread as far as the involute helicoidal tooth form is concerned. So it has got addendum, that is the radial distance between the pitch center, pitch circle and the outermost circle, and that is called as the addendum, whereas the radial distance between the root circle and the pitch circle is called as the dedendum. So addendum is 1m and dedendum is 2.2 cos of gamma minus 1 times the module, and the clearance is 0.2m cos gamma. So this is the way we have got different proportions for the worm. Outermost diameter of the worm is pitch circle diameter plus 2 times addendum, so qm plus 2m. That way we can calculate the root circle diameter, pitch circle diameter and addendum diameter. So all geometrical relationship we can calculate for worm, and similarly for worm wheel. So here are some equations which we are using to calculate different geometrical dimensions for the worm and worm wheel as the proportions. Now as far as the face width of the gear tooth is concerned, this is F is the face width of the worm wheel tooth, which is been calculated by considering the geometry. For example, it is the OAC triangle we can consider, in which AC is face width by 2. So AC square is face width by 2 square. So likewise, we consider the geometry of triangle OAC, and we can calculate this relationship, from which we calculate face width is equal to 2m plus root of q plus 1. So this is the way face width of the worm gear is required to be calculated by knowing its dimensions module and q. Similarly, we can calculate another requirement is a length of root of contact, that this is xyz distance, that is arc xyz is called the length of root of the contact worm wheel with the thread of the worm, and that has been calculated once again by considering the geometry as shown over here, and considering this angle delta we can calculate the arc, and from that we can calculate the LR, length of the root of contact. Now let us consider one example based upon all these proportions and previous simple equations for calculation. So a pair of worm gear is designated as 130-10-8, for which we have to calculate center distance, speed reduction and dimensions of worm and worm wheel. So as far as the solution is concerned, the given thing is specification of the worm gear set, for which Z1 is 1, Z2 is 30, Q is 10 and M is 8. with the help of these terms, we can calculate center distance A is equal to 1 half of d1 plus d2, that is PCD of worm, PCD of worm wheel, we can calculate, for which it is 1 half mq plus z2, so it is 160 mm. For step 2, we can calculate speed reduction, for which we know that velocity ratio is z2 by z1. So simply we substitute z2 as 30 and z1 is 1, so it is 30, velocity ratio is 30. The third calculation required is dimensions of the worm. So we are using all the previous equations, that is P circle diameter is qm, addendum diameter is there, tan of gamma is z1 by q. So substituting z1, z2, qm appropriately in particular equations, we can calculate all the dimensions of the worm and dimensions of the worm wheel. So by using all terminology, we can calculate all the geometrical dimensions of the worm and worm wheel as shown over here. This is my reference, Design of Machine Elements. Thank you.